Welcome to all of you. Today we are going to discuss our next topic, applications of Gauss theorem. Okay, we discussed earlier the statement of Gauss theorem and what is the proof of Gauss theorem. Okay, so before going to application of Gauss theorem, first of all you have to understand what is Gaussian surface, because Gaussian surface is very important for whatever the application in which we try to find the electric field. So we have most requirement of Gaussian surface. Okay, so Gaussian surface is what? Any hypothetical closed surface enclosing a charge is called Gaussian surface of that charge. Okay, any hypothetical closed surface. Okay, it's not a practical surface, it's a hypothetical surface we assume. Okay, enclosing a charge is called Gaussian surface of that charge. Okay, the surface around the charge. Okay, and it is chosen to evaluate the surface integral of the electric field produced by the charge enclosed by it. Okay, it is chosen to evaluate the surface integral of the electric field produced by the charge enclosed by it, which in turn gives the total flux through the surface. Okay, our interest to find the total electric flux of that surface. Okay, so we choose a proper Gaussian surface and find the electric flux and electric field and electric flux. Okay, what is important to find electric field easily without complications of Coulomb's law and superposition theorems. Okay, Gaussian surface provide a facility to find electric field without complications of Coulomb's law and superpositions. Okay, we choose that surface as a Gaussian surface which we can easily find the surface area. Okay, if we find the easily surface area and we can easily calculate the electric flux, because phi equal to integration of EdS cos theta. Okay, so if we have the value of ds, then we can easily calculate the electric flux. Okay, so write this. So our next topic is application of Gauss theorem. Okay, the application of Gauss theorem is very important to find the electric field and electric flux. Okay, so these are the application of Gauss theorem. First is field due to an infinitely long charged wire. Okay, what is the electric field due to infinite long charged wire? We can easily calculate using Gauss theorem. Second, electric field due to a uniformly charged infinite plane sheet. Okay, electric field due to uniformly charged infinite plane sheet. Okay, third, electric field due to uniformly charged thin spherical shell. And fourth, electric field due to uniformly charged insulating sphere. Okay, these are the four application of Gauss theorem. But now in this year CBSE remove these two and only you have to study these two, first one and second. These two application which you must remember their derivation and concept. No need to understand and write and learn this, because this two application CBSE has removed from your syllabus or deleted from your syllabus. Okay, so one by one we study these two applications. Okay. Okay, this is the very first application of Gauss theorem. Okay, what is electric field due to an infinitely long straight charge wire? Or question is like that, derive a relation for the electric field due to a uniformly distributed long infinite wire. So you have to derive the formula for the electric field due to infinite long charged wire. Okay, so before going to start our derivation, we first consider this is the infinite long straight wire. Okay, and this is the continuous distribution of charges or multiple charges. Okay, is the infinite wire, okay, having uniform linear charge density lambda per centimeter. Okay, and in our previous session we also defined linear charge density is what? Charge per unit length. Okay, so this is the linear charge density lambda per centimeter. Okay, and to determine the field, a charge distance r, field at a distance r from the line charge and cylindrical Gaussian surface r, length l, and with its axis along the line charge. Please see here, this charge density, ye ek wire hai, is wire mein ek Gaussian surface कंसिडर किया जो सिलेंड्रिकल है. ओके, दिस इज द सिलेंड्रिकल क्वेश्चन सरफेस. व्हाई वी चूज द सिलेंड्रिकल सरफेस? बिकॉज दिस सरफेस इज सिमेट्रिकल टू दिस चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ओके, इसके सिमेट्रिकल हम कौन सा सरफेस बना सकते हैं? ये सिलेंड्रिकल एक परफेक्ट सरफेस हमने यहां पे बनाया, क्वेश्चन सरफेस. ओके, because we can easily calculate the surface area of this surface. Okay, now this is the length of charge, and if we consider the cylindrical surface, then this is the one circle and this is the second circle. So these are the radius from the axis to the surface. Okay, so this is the radius of this circular surface. Okay, now we consider three surface. First, surface 1, surface 2 and surface 3. Okay, there are three surfaces, and from these three surfaces we can easily calculate the total flux, okay, by Gauss theorem or our fundamental formula. So this is the plus charge. Okay, now first we consider this surface. This surface, what is the direction of the electric field at that point? The electric field at that point is radially outward, and radially outward and repulsive. Okay, the electrostatic force is repulsive nature, so electric field is in this direction. And what is the direction of area vector? Okay, the area vector is normal to that surface, so the normal is like this. So this is the ds1 vector. Okay, now for this surface, what is the direction of electric field? The electric field is radially outwards or in this direction. And what is the normal of this surface? The normal of this surface is like that. Okay, this is the normal and this is the normal for this surface. So the angle between electric field and area vector or surface is 90 degree, and here electric field is, here angle is 0 degree. Now for surface 3, electric field in this direction, but the normal area vector is normal to that surface. So this is the ds3. So theta equal to 90 degree. Okay, now resolve these three field and calculate the total flux passing through that surface and electric field. Okay, so please write all this thing. This is the consideration and this is the diagram. Okay, so from this diagram we have ds1 parallel to E. ds1, this is the ds1 parallel to E, so theta equal to what? 0 degree. And ds2 perpendicular to E. ds2 perpendicular to, so theta equal to what? 90 degree. And ds3 is perpendicular to E. ds3 is perpendicular to E, so theta is also 90 degree. So what is the formula for electric flux from Gauss theorem? Phi equal to what? This is the fundamental formula of electric flux. Okay, now later on we apply Gauss theorem. So phi equal to what? The whole integration of closed surface S EDS E vector dot DS vector. So this is the dot product, and in terms of various surfaces, so here integration of surface first EDS1 plus integration of second surface E vector dot ds2 plus integration of third surface E vector dot ds3. Okay, now if we write in terms of angle, so integration of surface first EDS1 cos theta equal to what for surface S1? 0 degree. And integration of second surface EDS2 cos 90 degree because theta is 90 degree, and EDS3 cos 90 degree. Okay, so what is the value of cos theta? Cos 0, cos 0 is 1 and cos 90 is 0, and this also 0. So we have only this surface. Okay, so please complete it. So phi equal to E, if we take E outside from integration, into ds1 plus 0 0 because cos 90 is 0 and in cos 90 is also 0. So E into what is ds1? ds1, this surface from up to this, so this is the curved surface. So area of curved surface you know very well for cylinder. What is the formula for area of curved surface of cylinder? That is 2πrl. So E into 2πrl. Okay, and now we know that linear charge density is what? Q by L, or Q equal to what? Lambda into L. So from Gauss theorem we have phi equal to what? Q by epsilon naught. Okay, so from equation first and second, LHS both are same, so we write from equation first and second, okay, E into 2πrl equal to what? Q by what is Q into what is the what is second? Phi equal to what? Q by epsilon naught. And what is Q? What is Q? Q by epsilon naught. So directly E equal to what? Q upon epsilon naught into 1 upon 2πrl. So what is Q? Q is lambda into L upon epsilon naught into 1 upon 2πrl. So L cancel here. Okay, so we can write electric field equal to what? Lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught into R. Okay, so this is the electric field due to infinite long straight wire. Okay, from what is conclusion? One conclusion is that electric field is directly proportional to the charge density and electric field is inversely proportional to distance. Okay, so one question is from here, what is the graph between electric field and distance? So the graph is like this. This is the electric field and this is the distance. So the graph is like this because it's the inversely proportional. Okay, so please write down, this is the electric field due to infinite long straight wire. Okay.